Hey guys, it's Danielle. In this part, we'll be animating our character in spine and creating a walk cycle for all 8 directions. We will also create an idle animation for each direction. If you are new to this tutorial series, be sure to check out the first 2 parts, where we created the character's PSD file and its rigging. A link for both the PSD file and the spine file is in the description below. I am starting this part with the character ready to be animated. We have all the bones placed and all the meshes we need. Right now, in the setup mode, this character is facing the south direction. In the previous part, we created a direction bank with the 5 directions we will animate today. So let's talk about animating a walk cycle. Searching walk cycle at Google will lead you to wonderful references. I recommend checking it out while you animate. I'm using it to double check my animations, and I promise you it's a lifesaver. A basic walk cycle contains 9 frames, when the last keyframe is a copy of the first. I choose to start with the east direction, as it is the most common view of a walk cycle. I start with the body, as its movement will affect the legs bending. Within the 9 keyframes, the body will move as follows: between, low, between, high, between, low, between, high, and between again. As for the legs, the 2 legs will move identically, but not at the same time. The legs in the 1st and the 5th keyframes will have contact with the ground, and in between those keyframes, the legs will move and switch places. At the 2nd keyframe, leg 1 will have full contact with the ground, and leg 2 will bend in the air. In the 3rd keyframe, the 2 legs will be in the same place in the middle. Leg 2, the bent one, will remain bent, and leg 1 will stay straight on the ground. Keyframe 4 will have the legs mirror the same position as the 1st keyframe, but leg 1 will be the place of leg 2 and vice versa. In the 5th keyframe, we complete a step of 1 leg. We do the same process from the 5th keyframe to the 9th keyframe, making the other leg take a step. By this, we get the walk cycle of the legs. When the front leg is in the back, the front arm will be in the front. When the front leg is bent, the front arm will be in the middle. And when the front leg is in the front arm will be at the back. To make the arm move more realistic and less robotic, I add a little motion to the head, causing a delay when following the movement of the arm. For those who have checked the spine file I provided, you probably saw I choose to place the finger bones under the arm bone and not under the hand bone. We will change the shear and the scale of the hand in the other direction's animation, and I didn't want the shear and the scale to affect the fingers. So for now, we make sure to rearrange the finger bones when we need it. I use the preview window to watch my animations while lowering the speed to find any mistakes. I always find something I want to change or correct, and most of the time, I will go back to animation I detailed finish and keep on changing its keyframes. I did this while filming the tutorial, so it's okay not to have a perfect animation right at the start. To add secondary motion to the animation, I animated the bends, moving it right and left between the keyframes of the walking. I also added a tiny movement to the face parts of up and down to make the animation more aligned. That's it for the east direction. Let's move on to the southeast direction. For the southeast direction, we duplicate the east animation and copy the southeast keyframe from the direction bank. We paste those at the first and the last keyframes. As you can see, it is not a smooth process, and we need to fix the in-between keyframes. A small tip for sane workflow: for each face part, copy the first keyframe and paste it on the existing ones. This way, the face won't keep breaking, and you can easily adjust the keyframes to regain the up and down movement. In this direction, our main walk will be on the ends, but in this animation, we will adjust the shear and the scale of the front hand. This way, we create an illusion of depth for the hand when it's reaching back. Of course, because I didn't want the shear and the scale to affect the fingers, we will need now to adjust the fingers' position and rotation. Next comes the south direction. For creating this direction, we will need to work harder. We duplicate the southeast animation and copy-pasting it to attach and draw others keyframe from the direction bank. Unfortunately, here we can't use the keyframes we did for the legs as it, and we will need to animate them again. Animating a front walk cycle may look a bit odd, but you will get used to it. The main difference between a front walk cycle and a side walk cycle is the position of the legs. When we animate the front walk cycle, we will only need to move the legs up and down. It has the same principles as before. We have contact with the ground, pressing down, passing, bending high, and contact again. Of course, we also need to reanimate the hands. When we finish with the south and southeast directions, we can duplicate the animations and place in them the attached keyframes of the north direction and the northeast direction. I always hope this process will be a smooth one, but most of the time I still need to fix and change a few keyframes. And that's it! We now have a walk cycle for 8 directions. To achieve the west and the northwest directions, we will use our existing animation and mirror them with a script at our game engine. We are using Unity, but it will also work with any other game engine, like Unreal. You will learn how to make and get a script in the 5th part of this tutorial series, so stay tuned. Here is an extra small tip for creating an idle animation. After going through all the trouble to create a walk animation, idle is pretty easy. We want our character's idle to be as noticeable as it can. When the player briefly ignores the game, we will still want the game to look alive, and a good noticeable idle animation can help with that. Because this character is round, I choose to place the hand on its front to mimic a ball. So that's the end of the 3rd part of the 8 direction tutorial series. In the next part, we will add a weapon to our character and animate an attack animation, again for all the 8 directions. Thank you for following along. A link to this spine file is available to download in the description. Be sure to like and subscribe so you won't miss our next update. We also have other game dev tutorials about spine animation in Unity and our games devlog series, so we will be happy if you check it out. See you in the next part.